Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, TechnoTalks here. So today I'm going to be talking about the iPhone 12, as you can see in front of me, and I'm going to be giving y'all my thoughts about it after around 24 hours. So I did unbox this yesterday and I already have a video posted on it, and if you want to go check that out, it's already there. You can go ahead and check out my channel and check that video out, but if you've already seen it, go ahead and stay here and just listen to what I have to say. So as I said, when I was unboxing the phone, I was going to be doing a review after around a day just to give my thoughts on the device. And so far, I'm feeling pretty good about it. I have a lot of pros and a lot of things that I like to talk about that I really enjoyed about it. And then there's only one minor, maybe two things that I really didn't like a lot. But other than that, it's really good and I really enjoyed using this device. So let's go ahead and begin. First up, design-wise, this device just looks beautiful. I really loved holding this device in my hand, especially this matte finish on the side. I would love to have a matte finish on the back. As you can see, it already collected some fingerprints. But other than that, that really didn't bother me too much. It looked really nice. It feels really nice in the hand. However, what I did notice was after around like 2 hours of using it, of handling this device in your hand, these corners do start to hurt, especially since the iPhone is a little wide phone. So iPhones generally tend to be wider than most Android phones. With the width and also those sides being not curved, being straight, the edges kind of did start hurting my hand. I did feel a sensation in my hand that it just didn't feel comfortable. After a certain amount of time, it just doesn't feel comfortable, and you really don't want to hold the device in your hand, especially since it is a little heavier than most phones, and I am coming from an S21, so it's a little thinner, a little lighter, and so the corners aren't curved as well. That's why the design, by looks, this looks beautiful. There's no judging that. This device just looks really nice, really clean, and really beautiful. But as I said, handling, it does tend to start annoying. As me, personally, I'm not sure about other people that own this device, but me personally, it does start to annoy me a little more, and it does start hurting my hand a little. So I go ahead and use it for like an hour, and then I leave it for a while until I use it again. So another thing that I didn't really like were the speakers. So nothing about the loudness, so it's pretty loud, it's really enjoyable, but once you get to a certain point, so let's say you get to like 75% on a video or something, it gets louder, but the sound isn't as clear. You can definitely hear that it's not clear, and it makes a difference, because I went ahead and tested this out. I went ahead and got a different device, my S21, and I did go ahead and turn up the volume on that and on this. They both are really loud, but the one that was a lot clearer was the S21. So after a certain point, the sound does tend to get a little jittery. You can definitely notice it. And so it might be a disappointment for some people. Technically, it shouldn't annoy too many people too much, because you probably won't listen to something that loud most of the time. Plus, it doesn't affect it too much. So personally, it did. I did notice it. It's not something you won't notice, especially when you use a different device as well. But if you're someone that's been using an iPhone for a while, this will not affect you at all. You'll definitely not worry or need to worry about this, because it's not too big of an issue. I just went ahead and put it out there because I did notice it, and I went ahead and tested it, and then I found out that it was true. It's a little jittery compared to my other devices. So other than that, everything else is great about this phone. Battery life, I got a great around like 7 to 8 hours screen on time from 0 to 100 when I had 0 to 100% on my device. I got around like 8 hours of screen on time, which is really nice. And other than that, display. So the display is a little higher than 1080p. It's a little weird aspect ratio. I forgot what it was exactly, but it's something like 2300 and like 1100, so 2300 and like by 1100, something like that. So it's a little weird aspect ratio, but it is a little higher than 1080p, so the quality is really nice. The colors on the screen look very natural, and since there isn't like tweaking the display on this, you can't go ahead and get like a vivid mode or something like on most Android devices, but the colors do look very natural and they look really nice. So nothing wrong with the display. The display looks really beautiful, and you can definitely watch a lot of things on here. So one other thing that I really like about Most iPhones actually would be True Tone. I know that Samsung did implement something to their S21 series this year. It's like this color changing mode, which is like changes the colors based on your environment, the time of the day. And for iPhones, it's called True Tone. Not exactly sure what it's called on Samsung, but they've had it for a while now, and it actually helps a lot. It like changes the colors based on the brightness, based on the area you're at. Since if it's a lot brighter and it senses that, it'll change up the colors a little, which will help in seeing the screen. So that's another pro. And one final thing would be the cameras. The cameras are very consistent. So when taking photos with the ultra wide and the wide camera, so the main lens, I've had very consistent shots, and they've both been around the same color, so color does not really tend to change between the two shots. If you know, a lot of phones might change colors since it is a different sensor, and it will most definitely change colors. But with iPhone, with this iPhone, the iPhone 12 series, they've actually managed to keep it the same color, and you don't see any distortion. Like the colors don't shift between the two photos; they're very similar. If you do go ahead and try pixel peeping a little, you might find a little color change, but other than that, the photos look perfect and they're always constant. And you really don't have to do too much. You go ahead and pull out your phone, open up the camera, and you go on a shoot. That's it. So you don't have to deal with anything, you don't no focusing issues, none of that, and it's just perfect. So camera is gonna be a 10 out of 10 for me. You get to do a lot of things and it's very good. So you go out and pull out your camera, just press the photo button, the shutter button, and it takes your photo, and you will always be sure that you took a good photo, so you don't have to go out and check it. You can go out and go home and be confident that you took a good photo. So that's another pro right there. And that's probably about it. One thing that I did kind of enjoy would be MagSafe. It's a little convenient if you're using like the new magnetic accessories. MagSafe is like an optional thing. If you like it, you do. If you don't, it doesn't matter because it's just there. And if you want to use it, it's better to have it than to not. And so I'll go ahead and put that in the middle. It's not a pro or a con. It's just something that you can use, and it'll be a pro if you do use the accessories. And if you don't like it, then I guess it could be a con for you. But other than that, the MagSafe is pretty good and reliable. So one final thing would be a complaint that I've had for a while, and that would be the fact that you don't get USB-C. We've had Lightning for years now. We got the USB-C to Lightning, so it's kind of weird that they didn't do USB-C to USB-C, but they went ahead and did USB-C to Lightning, and I also didn't really like that. Since I have tons of USB-C to C cables, and it would be nice to be able to use them, and they're all fast charging. And with the new fast charging capabilities of 20 watts, which is another pro, let me go ahead and add that into there. 20 watts fast charging, which is something really nice to have on an iPhone since you really didn't get that before. You would have 5 watt charging up until the iPhone 11 Pro Max. So that's basically about it now. Those were my complaints, not too big complaints. Like let's say this screen refresh rate could be another one, but I've gotten used to it, so I'm not gonna add that into here. It does have a 60 Hz refresh rate. Might be a disappointment or a con for some people, but me personally, I got used to after using it for a day, and so I really didn't want to add that into the video. So other than the three things that I talked about, the three main things that I didn't like, everything else is perfect on this device, and you'll really enjoy it. And if the software doesn't affect you too much, like let's say when you're switching from Android to iOS, then you'll be perfectly fine. I've owned iPhones before, and I've used iPhones, Androids together a lot, so it didn't affect me. And so software is not a letdown for me. I like iOS and I like Android, and I'm able to use both of them, so it didn't really affect me. So other than that, that's gonna be it for this video. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. And also, if you do know some things that you don't like about the phone or you like about the phone, go ahead and leave down a comment down below so I can see what you like and what you don't like. And that's about it. So I'll see you in the next video.